Hi guys, good morning, afternoon, evening, whenever you happen to be doing this. It's Mr. Ash, and the lesson that I'm going to be doing is expanding brackets. That's expanding single brackets, to be exact. Now, this is the first one where I've tried to make it more of a lesson, so there'll be times where you pause it so you can have a go yourself, and then I'll go through the answers. So hopefully it feels a bit more like if I was teaching it to you as normal. So let's see how it goes, and please do message, put comments on the homeworks or anything if you need any extra help with anything, or if you can't find anything, or whatever it is. All right? Okay, so expanding brackets, single. Let's just go through, we're going to go through a few questions, and then I'll give you some practice, like I said. So, question one. So, what we're doing with expanding is we're just looking at multiplying the thing on the outside by both the things on the inside. So I'm going to be doing 3 lots of x, which we don't know what x is, but we know that 3 lots of x would just be 3x, and then 3 lots of 5. 3 lots of positive 5, which is, of course, 15, positive 15. Because it's positive 15, we put a little plus here between them. It wouldn't just be 3x 15. You've got to have that 3x plus 15. And that is actually it. Okay, let's have a look at this next one. Straight away, getting a little bit harder. We've got a negative on the outside there. Other than that, it's exactly the same. We're going to be doing negative 4 times the x, which is negative 4x. Okay, and then we're going to be doing negative 4 times the 8. Negative times a positive is a negative again. 4 times 8 is 32, and you leave it at that. Okay, that's it, done. Right, next questions. Getting a little bit increasingly harder as we go down, really. In fact, I'm going to do 3 and 4 now. Okay, so minus 5 times y is minus 5y. Now, this question, really, I'm just trying to make it clear that this doesn't have to be an x. It could be a y, it could be an a, it could be a b, it could be anything you like, really. Exactly the same sort of thing. Minus 5 times y, minus 5y. And then minus 5 times minus 2. Negative times a negative makes a positive. So we're left with positive 5 times 2, 10. That's it. Done. Okay. Oh, I'm going to keep it at that. 4. X times 2x. So getting a bit harder still. You've got now an x multiplied by x. Now, I just write that up here, x times x. If you've got an x and you multiply it by another x, if you ever time something by itself, that's the same as squaring it. So x times x, we would write x squared. So x times 2x would be 2x squared, because it's x times 2 times x. The x and the x make the x squared, and the times by 2, 2x squared. Then the x times the plus 7 will give you plus 7x. So far, with all four of those questions, I've just done the bit on the outside times by both the things on the inside. Right, last two questions of the examples. Getting a lot harder now. This bit, basically, we've just got it separate. In fact, this would actually say, rather than just expand, all the others would say expand, and then whatever it is. So all of these would just be expand this, expand. This would actually say expand and simplify. So we need to make sure we do both. We expand it. First, I'm going to do this bracket, which gives me 6x plus 15. Then I'm going to expand this one, which gives me 4 times 2x. Remember, that's a plus 4 because it's got a plus there. 8x minus 12. And then we're going to take the 6x and the plus 8x and put them together. And we're going to take the plus 15 and the minus 12 and put them together. That's just that's the simplifying part. Expanding we did, and then we've simplified by putting the x's together and the numbers together. 14x plus 3. And then the last proper extension question, those two, both extension questions there. X squared times 3x squared. X squared times 3 well, just 3, because we've got no number here, so it's almost like 1 times 3. And then x squared times x squared. Well, let's have a little note over here. X squared means x times x. We're timesing that by x squared again, so it times another x times x. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4 x's all times together. Okay, x does make it quite tricky with these time signs, but trust me, they're the x's. So we've actually got now 3x to the 4. Okay, because the x squared times the x squared is x to the 4. Then we've got 7, 1 times 7 sort of, because there's nothing there. X squared is the same as 1x squared. Maybe that helps. We'll check that in there for you. And then x squared times the y part is, we write just x squared y. Just put them together. Like a times b, we just write ab. Okay? So, I've got some practice questions for you. I'm going to do it in 2 halves. There's, oh, let's try and make it so it's in the right place. There's the first 6. So, if you pause that to have a go at it, and then unpause it when you're finished, then I can go through the answers. So there they are. Pause. Okay, hopefully you paused. And now let's go through these. So 4 brackets x plus 3. You should be getting 4x plus 12. I'll go through these a lot quicker. Okay. Number 2. 5 times x is 5x. 5 times minus 7 is minus 35. Number 3, minus 2 times x is minus 2x. Minus 2 times plus 5, minus 10. Minus 3 times y is minus 3y. Minus 3 times minus 2. Minus times minus makes a plus, so 3 times 2 is 6. 8 times 3x is 24x, and 8 times 1 is 8. And then over here, 7 times 5 is 35. Doesn't matter the fact that the x is on the right, you just do the same thing again. 7 times 5, 35, and then 7 times 2x plus 14x. Okay? Right, another opportunity to pause now, so I'm going to give you all those questions, so loads this time. Question 7 to 13 there, extension right in the bottom corner, don't miss that one. Okay, if you pause it now, right, so hopefully you paused that, you had a go, and now let's go through the answers. So, x times x, x squared, x times 3, 3x, 4x times x is 4x squared. 4x times minus 5 is minus 20x. 2x times 3x is 6x squared. 2x times plus 2 is plus 4x. 5x times 3x is 15, because 5 times 3 is 15, x times x, x squared. So 5, 3 is 15, x times x, x squared. And then the 5x times the minus 4y is minus, because it's positive times negative. 5 times 4 is 20, x times y is actually xy. Down here. Expand this one out first, 8x plus 12, then expand this bit. 2x, that's plus 2x times plus, plus 14, not times plus 14, 2 times 7, 14. And then that simplifies to, we've got the 8x and the 2x, which is going to give us 10x. And we've got the 12 and the 14 simplified, 26. Okay. This one, expanding this, is 15x minus 10. Minus 3 times x is minus 3x. And minus 3 times minus 9, loads of people make this mistake, so don't panic if you did. Minus times minus makes a plus. 3 times 9 is 27. So you've got like a double negative bit going on there, giving you a positive. Lots of people make that mistake and leave that as a negative, so be careful there. Then we're going to put the 15x and the minus 3x together, giving us 12x. 15 take 3. And the minus 10 and the plus 27, they don't have x's in, so they're like terms, they're the same. So 27 take 10, or minus 10 plus 27, both ways, that will get you plus 17. And the very last one, really nasty one that I chucked in there, x to the 4 times 3x. Well, you've got almost like a hidden 1 there, so that's just going to be 1 times 3, 3. And then the x 4 to the x, times the x bit would give us x to the 5, because that's 1, 2, 3, 4 x's times our fifth x. Then the next bit, 1 times 5 is 5, and x to the 4 times another x and another x is x to the 6. Okay. Right. That's the expanding part of the lesson. I'm just going to go on to factorising next. So I'll put that in another video just so it's all broken down.